cars are interesting because what the concept is, they scan a given piece of land. So scanners basically have sensors. These sensors gather the electromagnetic radiations which are obtained either through the visible network or through the infrared network or through the microwave network. So either through the visible light or through the infrared light or the microwave, they basically gather the information. So these sensors detect the electromagnetic radiation and basically the subject, the various objects are being explained. So what is used is MSS, which is multispectral sensors. Now scanners, now multispectral scanners are special kind of sensors which have a field of view. So let's say they have a mirror attached to it and this mirror scans a given area. So this mirror can either be fixed or has a capability to move and rotate, and with this mirror the detection of the area would be taken into account, and the total area that is covered in one swipe is known as the swath. So swath is the area that is being covered by the sensor or the scanner. Now this multi-spectrum sensors can be in two types. They can be across track or along track. Remembering the across track and along track is very, very simple. We'll do it with a simple demonstration that we have created for you. But to understand is, whenever there are signals that are received to the scanners, those signals are converted into numeric value, which is the digital numbers. And these digital numbers are recorded on a magnetic tape. So let's first talk about a scanner, which is the whisk broom, which is also known as a cross track. So what happens in this case? In this case, as the scanner moves, it swipes the region across. It is moving across. So as you can see, the broom which is moving here, it is across, and this is the angle of view that is covered. The area which is being covered on the ground is known as scan swath. Now this satellite is interesting because the mirrors are rotating and the field of the view is around 90 degrees to 120 degrees that is there, and this mirror, since it moves, it covers a wider area. It moves left to right, right to left, and covers a huge area. So this whisk broom scanners are also known as the across track scanners. Now we have talked about the across track. There is a similar term which is along track. Now along track scanners are those scanners which are what they are called as the push broom. So rather than moving right and left as we have seen, what do a push broom scanner does? It moves simply along with the satellite. So it simply traces the satellite in the same path, and this is a push broom scanner. Again, this is the region which is the scan swath, or the region which is covered on the ground, and then we have the angle of view. We have the instantaneous angle of view that is there, and then we also have the total area that is being covered, and that is the swath, which is the width which actually is being covered by a satellite in one go. So there are two important types of scanners, the multispectral scanners that are there. One is the whisk broom and the next is the push broom scanners. The whisk broom scanners move across the line. However, the push broom move along in the same direction of the satellite, and that's the major difference between both the scanners that exist.